So the prologue is actually interesting because you talk about yourself, and despite going to one of the best universities in the world, you say that you're basically self-taught.
Yes.
Did you not get taught Pali in university?
Not really. It was rather a bit shocking, actually, because I myself had switched from studying Latin and Greek to studying Sanskrit, and the Sanskrit course in Oxford was about three quarters, or a bit more than three quarters, about Sanskrit, and then what they called a subsidiary language you could choose from several, which they offered you, and Pali was one of those, but very little attention was paid to it. It didn't get much weight, for instance, in the final examinations. You had to take two papers on Pali, but that's not very much. And my teacher, Professor Thomas Burrow, was a rather famous philologist of Sanskrit. He'd written a book about the Sanskrit language, as well as lots and lots of articles, but he didn't read these texts for what they said. He was only interested in how they said it. He was purely onto language. And when it came to Pali, well, that wasn't his field particularly, and he didn't actually really want to teach it at all. So he just would give me a book and say, read this. Not a book about Pali. He never, ever told me of anything which could be read about Pali, but he just encouraged me to, prepare myself for the exam, is the blunt and accurate way of putting it. The funny thing is that in the term when I was supposed to start Pali, he was away on leave. Okay. And there was a professor from Calcutta called Professor Bhattacharya, who was in the Linguistic Survey of India. And he and Professor Burrow did field work together in India on languages spoken by very small minorities in India, most of which are Dravidian languages, they're not related to Sanskrit or Pali at all. And they went away and did their thing. They were doing research. And then Professor Bhattacharya was brought over to Oxford to work with Professor Burrow, and he was also asked to teach me. And he taught me in the time-honored Indian way, namely that we started on page one of Geiger's grammar, which I've already mentioned, and he more or less dictated to me what was on the printed page in front of both of us. Not a very enlightening way of studying anything.
I don't think they get away with that these days.
Well, there was nobody in those days who told you not to do it this way. Professor Bhattacharya was a very amiable man. He knew a lot about his own subject, which was certainly not Pali. He probably depended on Geiger's grammar for his knowledge, which he passed on to me in quotes. And so I really was not well taught at all. And when I, through a series of fortunate accidents, fortunate for me that is, became lecturer in Sanskrit and Pali sometime after getting my degree, I was really rather upset that I had to teach this language, which I felt I had never been taught properly and didn't know very well. But I discovered that there was somebody in Cambridge. That's the advantage of having two universities at the top of the hierarchy, Oxford and Cambridge. There was somebody in Cambridge called K.R. Norman, who was really quite an expert on Pali, a world expert, in fact. And he was very, very short of pupils for years at a time. He didn't have any pupil in Pali. And so when I said the first time that I had leave, could I come over, stay in Cambridge? I had a friend with whom I could lodge. Could I come and have some Pali lessons from you? And he was really very pleased, because not anything about me, but he was just pleased that he had a pupil. And so I came with all my questions and we started reading Pali, and I owe a good deal of my knowledge of Pali to my teaching by Professor Norman. Though once I'd got to that higher level, I, of course, could do rather better at teaching myself than had been the case originally. Mm. So that's how I got into Pali, and most of that is not recorded in this little book. because it's not very credible.
I think people who might be watching this interview might be at least encouraged to learn that you were mostly self-taught.
It's not a good way to learn anything. And I mean, in those days also, there were very few works of reference. I was Warder's introduction to Pali, which is quite a good book, though it's got its mistakes and disadvantages, that only came out after I'd started learning Pali. So there wasn't even a decent primer. There were some very old-fashioned ones.
I see. Okay.